Next on our agenda is the report for the Friends of the Cumberson Toltec, and I'd like to call on President Tim Tennant to tell us what's going on with the Friends.
Well, as Bill pointed out, I was just thinking about it. It's been 15 months since we met in Antonito, I believe. It was early February of 2020. So it's nice to see people's faces, that's for sure. Last year was a challenging year as well for us, although we had some folks come out and we were able to do some work sessions in Antonito and in Cumberus. So we did have a presence, not nearly like we have normally, but so people are chomping at the bit. I think as society as a whole wants to get out and do things, so do Friends members, which is a testimony to the organization. They want to get back out and work on the railroad they love. So Stothy had mentioned a project which since 2009 has taken place in Colorado Springs and then the follow-up work more recently here in Antonito, but and you got my report obviously with all the pictures. Dan, I purposely put more pictures in for your benefit.
For those of us who can't read.
Yeah, no. It because it is pretty astounding what has been done with the tourist sleeper that will be part of the historic train set, as Stothy had mentioned. And it came back down to Antonito and got the trucks underneath it, and the guys are finishing up some work here and there. But I think it's something we can be very proud of, and a dedicated group that have been working on it. And what is interesting, and I think John Ings, I know, has commented about this, that when you think about the purpose of the car was to bring immigrants out to this part of the country, and you know those beds are not very soft because they are bed people slept on them. And they're very narrow, so I think people were a lot smaller, right, as far as we understand. We weren't as wide-bodied, more Learjet type, if you're using an aviation analogy. So,
Tim, I have a question. In all your research, did they sleep, because there were two on each berth, right?
Right.
Okay, so there were four people. In these berths that are this wide, do you sleep toe to toe or nose to nose, or how did this work?
I don't think I'd want someone's toes in my nose, though. back then, when people didn't take showers every day or twice a day, but anyway, the tourist sleeper that project is wrapping up and obviously be on display for the special trains. The Iron Horse, the Friends have a train scheduled for September 25th from Antonito to Osier. That'll be a photo charter with the historic train set. So it's going to be on display and running, which is fantastic. We don't want it to collect dust. We want it to be out there running. So that's fantastic. So I mentioned this year's going to look a little more normal than last year, and because people are signing up, registrations are coming in. We have a full slate of work sessions in addition to the special sessions F1 and F2, which will support the Iron Horse event, and so we're going to be really pushing that out as we define the events better. We also have our Moonlight and Wine Tasting Train coming up on Friday, July 23rd. We had to pause that last year, like a lot of stuff. So that will be running out of Chama on that Friday to Osier and return, like we've done over so many years. And so we're looking forward to that. Some of the projects that I'll mention a couple we talked about yesterday in our HPCC meeting was, well, I know one thing you're going to talk about and approve is the 163 baggage car. So, you know, we need to find something to do, not me, but our Colorado Springs folks. So obviously, what is that? So the commission's going to be approving moving baggage car 163 up to Colorado Springs. So the fellows up there don't run out of something to do. And so that's that project. Yesterday we talked about the lava pump house. Certainly that needs some work. So that's a big project, which will include roof replacement. And then most of you who traverse back and forth by Cumbres knows the work Bob Conry accomplished last year on the car inspector's house. So a couple things finishing up this year, we have to get SHPO approval, will be a new chimney, so that's one, and then it'll be new roof for the car inspector's house. So we have to get approval for that along with sublet. So, and then, you know, we'll be working on cars and that sort of thing. So, and Rich and his docents will be doing what they do best, riding trains and being our good ambassadors. And I don't know if I have much else to say, but.
Tim, I would like to especially thank you for the efforts on 470. I saw it back when it was a skeleton sitting in the tent there in Colorado Springs. And it was so exciting for one reason, really. The Friends have worked very diligently on an aspect of this railroad that doesn't get the same amount of notice that the passenger fleet does, namely all of the non-revenue things that are part of this railroad. So the freight equipment, we don't see that operating unless you happen to be part of the tours that or the charters that we do. It does sit in the yard, it does give the feel and the look, the authentic feel and look of what this railroad was really about, that it wasn't necessarily focused on passengers. But the 470 is actually going to join in with the passenger equipment and contribute to the revenue inflow. And this is a new venture in that sense. So it forms a hallmark that I wanted to use to demonstrate how important the Friends' work is to all of the success that we're talking about here today. Thanks.
Well, thank you. Yeah, it's a very dedicated crew. And I have to say, I was just looking at some notes here. In spite of COVID last year, we did accumulate about 6,600 plus work session volunteer hours, which not too bad, given, again, how much we were restricted. So there you go.
And absolutely our deepest thanks to the Friends, because they do the things on the contributing resources to the railroad that we would never have the financial means or labor means to do. So thank you. Please.
Well, thanks for letting us do what we do, and we appreciate the community of Chum and Aunt Nito for letting us come how many times a year. So anyway, and to Eric and the staff at the railroad for letting us, and maybe sometimes we're a nuisance. I know, Marvin, great to stay out of your ear. John. But we appreciate, you know, all the help you guys give us. So,
yeah. Thanks, Jim.
The next category is new business.